Rusty Young got his musical start in Benzie Creek, a Denver-based band whose odd moniker was inspired, perhaps apocryphally, by the local business sign on an appliance store.
George Grantham was their drummer, and he came to Don Edwards, and we used to have these jam sessions when there was nobody there, and I think I was doing a Hendrix song on Steel with the Fuzz Tone. George came in and saw me, and then he said, "Would you be interested in seeing how you fit in with our rock and roll band?"
Getting local airplay, a single got placed with Uni Records, and the double-sided 45, Still in Love with You Baby,
Still in Love with You Baby,
backed with Sky Gone Gray, went to number one on the hit list of KIMN, Denver's dominant top 40 station, in April 1967. On the West Coast, Richie Furay had formed Buffalo Springfield with Stephen Stills and Neil Young. The group had only one major hit, Stills' ominous protest song For What It's Worth. But Furay's songs made the Springfield perhaps the first rock band to experiment with a country sound. His best-known track with Springfield was Kind Woman.
Kind woman, don't leave me lonely tonight,
which he wrote for his wife, Nancy. The band was looking for a pedal steel guitarist for the ballad, and Furay called his friend from Colorado, Rusty Young, to play on the session. Guitarist Jim Messina was Buffalo Springfield's recording engineer who doubled as a bass player in the band's final days. In 1968, with Springfield in disarray, Furay and Messina quickly set about assembling a band of their own to continue injecting country influences into rock songs. They recruited Young, who called in two buddies from Colorado, drummer George Grantham from Benzie Creek, and bassist Randy Meisner, who came from a rival Colorado band, The Poor. The new band originally called itself Pogo, but Walt Kelly, the creator of the Pogo comic strip, sued. Poco started out with great commercial promise when the band's Pickin' Up the Pieces album debuted in 1969. Meisner left to later co-found the Eagles, and Messina slipped into the Poco bass slot until Timothy B. Schmidt signed on in February 1969. In November of that year, after Messina split to form a prosperous duo with Kenny Loggins, former Illinois Speed Press guitarist Paul Cotton stepped in, giving Poco a harder sound. Fun and innovative band, Poco made their reputation as a top-notch, exciting live act, getting rave notices for their tight, energetic, and upbeat sets. The band's 1971 live album, Deliverin', was its biggest seller of the era. At its best, Poco sounded like none of the other California country rock outfits, playing a bright, positive, romantic, and joyous music.
Colorado!
In 1971, the band members moved to Colorado. While walking down a road to his house near Nederland, Furay wrote one of Poco's most distinctive compositions.
Good 1973's
A Good Feeling to Know.
Somebody loves you.
The parent album reached number 69 on Billboard's pop album chart, but the crowd-pleasing title track failed to generate the expected commercial success. Frustrated, Furay left Poco in September 1973 to join the Souther Hillman Furay Band, a ready-made supergroup assembled by record mogul David Geffen. Furay wrote Fallen in Love, the group's sole hit, which peaked at number 27 on Billboard's pop singles chart in 1974. The band evaporated after 2 years. During the recording of its second album at Caribou Ranch in Nederland, Steel guitarist Al Perkins, a former Flying Burrito brother and a member of Manassas, suggested Furay consider Christianity as an alternative lifestyle. He did. Nearly a year after injuring his hand while chopping wood near his Colorado home, Furay reemerged and pursued a solo career, one of the first rock stars to make Christian music for the general market, recording 3 albums. I Still Have Dreams debuted on Billboard's pop singles chart in October 1979. In 1982, Furay abandoned music and devoted himself to pastoring Boulder's 150-member Rocky Mountain Christian Fellowship, now Calvary Chapel in Broomfield. Poco had plugged on following Furey's departure, recording such classics as Schmidt's Keep On Trying,
Keep On Trying,
Young's Rose of Cimarron,
Rose of Cimarron,
and Cotton's Indian Summer.
Indian Summer.
But they had to watch the Eagles adopt Poco's sound and emerge as the triumphant beneficiaries of the country rock era. When Meisner left the Eagles, Schmidt quit Poco to take his place. Young alone remained of the original lineup. He, with Cotton, had it with Poco. Withstanding personnel changes, clueless label execs, and other trials and tribulations. But the band released one more record as Poco in 1979. With Legend, its 12th studio album, Poco finally cracked the top of the charts, the breakthrough at last. Young, fittingly, wrote and sang on the Gold Album's surprise hit single, Crazy Love.
It happens all the time, this crazy love of mine wraps around my heart, refusing to unplug.
Cotton's Heart of the Night was a second top 20 hit.
In the heart of the night.
Legend resurrected the Poco spirits. More albums followed until Young orchestrated a Poco reunion of the five original members in 1989, urging Furey to give the rock world one more try, and involving Messina, Grantham, and Meisner. Poco's legacy album contained the top 20 hit, Call It Love, and earned a gold record.
You have Randy Meisner, you have Jimmy Messina, you have Richie Furey, so you have Poco, Buffalo Springfield, Lonnie Messina, Eagles. All four that started in the same band, playing in the same band. What other American band has that kind of legacy?
Furey, a longtime Colorado resident, continues to record and perform with the Richie Furey Band. The team of Young and Cotton carried on until 2010. Young, the Colorado native, has remained the only member who has performed at every Poco gig and played on every Poco recording since the band's inception.